expeditiously to recommend to the full Senate his nomination. Now, if I may, let me say just a few words about our second nominee, David Guaderrama. Of course, as Senator Hutchison pointed out, Judge Guaderrama currently serves as a United States Magistrate Judge, so he has a very up-close and personal view of the federal dockets in one of our busiest districts in Texas and indeed in the United States. That's the Western District of Texas in El Paso. Like Mr. Costa, Mr. Guaderrama was a consensus nominee recommended by to the President by our bipartisan Federal Judicial Evaluation Committee. Of course, Judge Guaderrama possesses a wealth of experience and to qualify him for this honor, and he has learned the value of hard work at an early age, serving as a hand on his family's farm in New Mexico. During college, Judge Guaderrama also worked a variety of jobs, including positions as a gas station attendant and furniture delivery man. And I mention those only because of my firm conviction that it's important that judges who preside over these very important cases understand not only a legal perspective, but the perspective of not the jurors and the people who seek access to justice in our courts. And so I think the breadth of his legal experience and his personal experience will help him in that regard. Like Judge Guaderrama, as I indicated earlier, I'm both a former state district court judge and I was former gas station attendant, and I can't help but wonder whether the long days pumping gas in the Texas heat somehow uniquely prepared both of us for our jobs as judges. And to this day, I still have questions which job was actually better. In all seriousness, Judge Guaderrama had bigger plans, and he went to school, as you've heard, at Notre Dame Law School. After law school, he gained extensive experience in El Paso, as you've heard, and I believe that given the large number of criminal and narcotics cases occupying the federal docket in El Paso, coupled with the procedural complexities that they often present, that Judge Guaderrama's experience with both of these type of cases will well qualify him. So, Mr. Chairman, thank you for allowing Senator Hutchison and myself both to come before the committee this morning and recommend these two consensus nominees. It's my sincere hope that Chairman Leahy will put these nominations after this hearing on a markup. We can get them voted out of committee. We can get them to the floor of the Senate, and that Senator Reid will allow us the opportunity to confirm both of these outstanding nominees so they can go on to serve the people of our state and of our country in these important positions. Thank you very much.
Thank you to both senators for your very